Hello, it's Keith here, and this is lesson 29 of the platform-specific series of my 6502 assembly programming tutorials. Now, we've looked at sound on various systems over the last few weeks, and this week we're going to look at the VIC-20. Now, compared to the graphics on the VIC-20, which are a little bit limited, the sound is actually fairly respectable, at least for what I was planning to do, compared to things like the Spectrum, you know, very, very decent. Now, the VIC-20 uses three tone channels, one noise channel, and then a control to set the volume. These are all memory map ports, as usual, 900A to 900E. Now, the tone channels each work at a different frequency range, so we have a low tone, a mid-tone, and a high tone, and these are three separate channels, so we can set them all simultaneously, but obviously, they don't really overlap with regards to the tones they create, so it's not like we can create three-channel music in a more conventional sense, but it's like they're very good. Now, the first bit of each of these, the highest bit, will turn that channel on, and the remaining seven bits are the actual pitch that the tone channel is going to output. The noise channel is basically the same. We have a frequency for the noise, and we can turn that on or off. Now, the final one, the volume port, 900E, has a bottom nibble which defines the volume, but the top nibble actually has another purpose. This actually sets the auxiliary color for the graphics, so if we're going to write to that, we need to make sure we're careful to retain that, otherwise our graphics may go wrong. Now, when I started programming the 6502, I'd already done the Z80 series, and we wrote something called Chibi Sound. This took a single byte in the accumulator and defined a sound according to that byte. And when I created Grime 6502, I copied that function across with comparable functionality, and so we're going to have a look at that today. Now, Chibi Sound takes a single byte, six of the bits define a pitch, with the lower numbers being the higher pitch, and the sixth bit is the volume bit, either high or low, one being high. And then the last bit, bit 7, is the tone. If it's a 1, then we create a noise effect. If it's a 0, then we create a tone, usually a square wave. And that's what we're going to be doing today. So let's see Chibi Sound in action. So here it is. Very simple. We just load up the accumulator, run Chibi Sound. There's a slight pause here, a bit of code to do that. And then we just decrement the accumulator. So let's hear Chibi Sound actually working. So here you can see the accumulator is going down, and you can see that the tone is changing accordingly. And now we're repeating again, this time slightly quieter. And when we go to the FF range, because the top bit is now 1, you can hear we've got a distortion sound, but you can hear the tone is changing once again. Okay, that's enough of that. So, how does this actually work? Well, here's the Chibi Sound program. It's pretty straightforward. So what we're effectively doing is we are loading the accumulator with the sound byte before we run Chibi Sound. So we're pushing that onto the stack because we need to back it up. Now, the first thing we're doing in the case of the VIC-20 is we're getting the pitch bits, the six bits here. Because remember, we've got six bits of pitch. Now, we're actually flipping them over because by default, the VIC-20 works the opposite way around to Chibi Sound. The pitch becomes higher as the numbers go higher, but with Chibi Sound it goes lower. It depends on the system. Different ones work in different ways, so we need to be consistent. So what we're doing is we're taking the six bits here, but then we're shifting them one bit to the left because the VIC-20 actually uses seven bits, so we're shifting the six bits of our definition to here. Then we're setting the top bit to 1, and we're storing that in the Y register, and then we're loading the X register with 0. Well, why are we doing this? Well, we're either going to make a noise effect, in which case we're going to need to load this definition into here, or we're going to need a tone effect, in which case we're going to load it into 900B. We're going to use the medium frequency. We could load into the low frequency or the high frequency for lower or higher pitch, but medium's most appropriate in this case. Now, because the definition is the same in all cases, we're going to need to load one with this definition with the tone, with the pitch bits just here and a 1 just here. And the one that's going to be turned off, we need to load with a 0. So what we've done here is we've loaded X with 0, Y with the correct pitch and turning on the channel, and then we're going to decide where we're going to write this depending on the top bit of the definition that was passed to us in the accumulator, that noise bit here. Now, after we pull the accumulator here, we're just checking if it's 0, because 0 is a special case where we're actually muting the sound. So what happens there is we jump here, and this code will actually set the volume, and we're going to have a look at that in just a moment. But if the accumulator is 0 and we jump to this point, effectively it will turn the channel off. And that's how we deal with turning the sound off in our game after any sound effect. So if the noise bit is 0, then we're going to jump to this no noise here. And we're just going to put the Y register into 90B to set the oscillator tone. and then we're going to send the X register, which was 0, to 90D, which is going to silence the noise. But if we're going to make the noise, we swap over Y and X, and then we'll set Y to 0, which will effectively silence the tone and use the defined pitch here for the noise. So we're kind of saving some code here, basically. So once we've got to this point here, we've now set the noise and the tone channel to the correct volume or turned them off, respectively. Now what we're going to do is we're going to use our volume bit. Now our volume bit is just here. Now we load this in here by adding it in, and then we shift it to the right a few times, and this is effectively moving it to here. But then we set the remaining three bits to 1 because 15 is the loudest volume, so we want a loud tone or a mid-tone, just depending on if our volume bit here is set or not. So that's what we're doing, and then we are storing that into ZAS, because next what we need to do is we need to get the current value of the port 900E. So we load that into the accumulator. We keep the top nibble, which remember is the alternate color. We then OR in the value we just calculated here that is in ZAS. ZAS is a zero page entry, so this is just a temporary store for us. And then we store this back to 900E. And that correctly sets the volume without altering the auxiliary color. And this is what I did in Grime 6502, because Grime 6502 did use the auxiliary color, and it would have made a right mess if I hadn't done that correctly. So there we go. Very straightforward, really, to do sound on the VIC-20. As I say, it's quite limited, but you know, there's plenty of potential there. Now, just for a bit of fun, one last thing we'll do, if we just run this here again. So that's the default port we're writing our sound settings to here. But if I change this to C here, and I run again. You can hear the pitch is much higher because we're now writing to that alternate port just here. And of course we can do the same. We can change it to A if we want, and then we're now writing to that bass port. So there you go. It's really quite straightforward to set the sound on the VIC-20, one of the easiest systems really, and as I say, for basic beeps like this, you know, perfectly adequate, very nice. So there we go, that's all we've got to cover for the VIC-20 today, because it's really so simple. Next time we're going to look at the Commodore 64, which is a bit more advanced and is going to be a bit more complicated. Hope you've enjoyed today's lesson anyway. Thanks for watching and goodbye. Now, if you have questions, comments or suggestions, please feel free to sign up to my web forums. Every tutorial episode has its own section on the forum. If we just click on these buttons here, you'll see it goes to a matching page of my forum. The forum's just at chibiacamas.com/forum. It's free to sign up, of course. You can show off your project you're working on. I totally encourage you to show us what you're working on. And if you've got any questions, any suggestions, please let me know them. It's purely an assembly forum. So if you're working on assembly programs and you want to show them off, please sign up and show us what you're working on. Thanks a lot.